only the mankind in this universe, apart from the other species, they progress to the level of establishment, development and prosperity, which is not there for the other members of this global community. They are very much framed within their survival, which has a limited means of exhibition of their instinctive desire and achievement of the same. So it is very much limited, and only the human beings, they are having trans-survival measures. Apart from survival, they want establishment, they want a comparative and absolute prosperity, competitive prosperity. So a lot of these instincts are only there in the advanced human beings. So whenever these type of the resources of the world in various forms, human being already, it has been told and very equally experienced also, that out of his spatial supremacy, as he considers himself to be the superior most person of all of the species, he considers each and every entity except him to be a source for his survival and development. So either he explores, experiments or exploits them for his development. And within the human community also, each human being considers the other person to be explored, experimented or exploited for his development. So it is also the mankind totally having a spatial supremacy, and also some kind man considering other men to be the sources of exploitation for his own growth and development. So these type of human beings in various forms with various caliber, acumen and application, that is, each and every human being, they will be limited with their own resources, either intellectual resources, physical resources, circumstantial resources. Each and everybody may not be equal to the other. Likewise, each and every person's competition and collective productivity creates a lot of cleavages between their economical levels. So the economy of nation, the fiscalism of the trade, and the monetarism of each and every family, and the financial position of regions are all controlled by only the dominant people. And the dominant people, if they are benevolent, they used to support the other people who are insufficient in resources. And if it goes to the malevolent people, it becomes a process of squeezing the other people. So support if it is in the beneficial hand, squeeze if it is in the maleficial hand. So always the society has been planned in such a way that it is either a select monopoly or a collective monopoly. So it is unavoidable. So such type of people taking this result of resources and continuously engage in the process of conception without caring much for the preservation, reservation, conservation and multiplicity, that will create lot of imbalances in the society. So first, what we have to understand is, whenever we are getting into a global entity or a global venture, the more we learn about the global venture, there we are benefited or at least secure. So these type of imbalances, they start with insufficiency and end in crisis. Insufficiency is the inadequacy that is available in the minutest order. And crisis, whenever it affects millions of people, and the impact of which shall take decades together for reconsideration and balancing, that is known as crisis. That which affects deeply, that which affects millions of people, and the restoration process of which shall take more than a decade, time consuming, mass consuming and impact consuming, such effects are known as crisis. So a small insufficiency in a very boosted and in a permeable scope, that gives you crisis. Now the world is facing three major crises. One is the food crisis, second is the energy crisis, and third is the water crisis. Based upon all of these things only, the independence and sovereignty and healthy economy between these things only, they determine the development of companies, where we are having the dividends in the form of stock values. So directly, the domestic factors and the transnational factors, there are two factors of study. Domestic factors, they can be easily governed, as we are the policy makers and we have our own lobby here. But when we are subjected to dependent economy, this known as dependent growth strategy, then immediately it is very difficult unless it is organized in a transnational or international scale. Food crisis is very major. See, it is known as anticipatory and predictive forces. There are three forces. One is whenever we are subjected to any problem, any crisis, that crisis that occurs now, it is known as contemporary or current. That which is about to occur, which can be understood by the global scenario, it is known as anticipatory. At any time it may happen. Predictive means by lot of the factors. For example, if a child is playing near the fire, then the impending danger is understood, that is known as predictive. If a lady who is near a lamp, if the border of the catches fire, that is anticipatory. So, depending upon the ratio or gravity of the impending danger, the prediction or the anticipatory system is understood. Anticipation is, it has started and it will end. Before even getting started, the predictive systems by means of symptomic study and analysis, that gives you a lot of factor. So this type of growth, one area, we are seeing number of buildings. There are three markets. The basic market is known as food market. Second thing is real estate or land market, and third thing is the stock value market. So whenever we are seeing in some area big new companies, new MOOs, lot of multinational companies launching in India and lot of Indians getting good jobs at multinational companies even abroad. So this type of atmosphere that shows utmost richness in one area. Why BMW it has launched this company here? Bentley, why it is going to start its assembly here? Why Rolls-Royce, even the most famous car, which is the dream of each and every car lover of the world, why is willing to establish these things here? Because of its availability of proper resources of purchase. Certainly, but it is only one side movement. On the other side, there is also lot of other crises which I have explained. The previous year it saw 75 million of people who are very much suffered with lack of proper nutrition and due to hunger. So these type of food, that is the basic value of the stock, that is known as the livestock and the lively stock and the livelihood stock, different types of stocks are there. So the basic materials, due to various other methods, for example, there are a lot of subsidies given. Subsidies is not only encouragement, but it induces sluggardishness and irresponsibility. And number two, mainly due to this petroleum price hike. And third thing is food and fuel. Now there is a combat between food and fuel. It has been told in one recent analysis that a person's annual consumption of maize, if it is converted into fuel, it can fill a tank of a car, just little. So to fill a tank of a car, we require the annual consumption of a person, one time filling. So these edibles, basically meant for our consumption and development, they are converted into cultivation of more things which are utilized for fuel extraction. Those fuels are very much meant for consumption, which are diverted for these fuels, and it has a very, very, very infinitesimal proportion when it is there for human consumption. If it is for fuel adoption, it is a voracious eater which is exploits all the resources of cultivation. There are lot of such things are there. So unless a person understands the global crisis of food, energy, 2010 is the year of water crisis, and the energy crisis 2015 they announced, but they have somehow announced 2020 is going to be a prosperous year. I don't know how it is possible. So this is how we have to understand these three major things. Now let us come to the current status of inflation that wounds the Indian economy. Inflation is no doubt, you know, that there are lot of economical imbalances such as deflation, inflation, hyperinflation, stagnation, recession, innumerable abnormities are there in economy. And inflation is always defined as the rise of increase in the price of goods and services, which underestimates or undervaluates the unit of currency. The value of a currency, that is a unit of currency, is totally minimized by means of this inflation. So this type of inflation, no doubt it is very essential. In refrigerators you might have seen, don't be afraid of the heat that is stimulated from this refrigerator, which is very unavoidable for the functions inside. and it is very harmonious and salubrious to the functions of that. It is a normal procedure exhibition of the refrigerator. So inflation is very essential for it boosts the person. If there is no inflation at all, that is known as salubrious or reasonable inflation, that is known as moderate inflation, or it is always known as salubrious inflation. So if inflation is not there, then there are two other possibilities which are very worse than inflation. One is a zero inflation status. That is also not required. If inflation is not there, it will result in deflation. That is worse than this inflation. So a reasonable hike in the prices of goods or services, they are totally unavoidable. But whether it is healthy or not, that we have to take into proper account. So according to the calculation, both in the Arthashastra and in the modern pursuit, whenever there are two things. These things are common. Whatever you can invent newly, there are some things which are universal constants and commons, which we cannot just change at all. One is known as Svikriti. Svikriti means that is the demand. Vitarana means supply. So to give and take. Dana Svikarana, Dana Pratikraha, these things are the eternal dvandvas, eternal couplets. So whenever there is a demand and supply, that has an improportionate relation between each other. Even a basic commerce student can understand, 10th standard student can understand that there is inflation and there is going to be regularity. How to manipulate these things is known as the work of the government or work of the so-called technicians of economical construction or financial resurrection. That is the duty of these people. Is it known as government? Whenever a person in the society is suffering, who is imbalanced and who is also imbecile, not capable of constructing his own self, it is the duty of the responsible citizen or the organization of the state to reinstall the position of the person, at least for the basic amenities like food, education, medicine, etc. That is known as government. So government is a maternal organization. It does the work of a mother who shares the resources, enjoys the resources to be shared between the people with the subsidies, grants, aid, opportunities. Then various other processes are given by, so it is a motherly organization, this government, it has to do that. That's why I used to say, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu need not be the statement of spiritual persons. Even those who are in trade and commerce, they have to say, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. If there is some problem with the lorry owners and between the wages between the lorry operators, and there is a strike, then you cannot get any product delivered to you. Then totally it will disorganize the whole transportation system at all. So we have been forcefully made in such a situation that we have to daily utter Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Let Middle East be prosperous, due to which the oil flow and supply will be very perennial and conducive to us. Let US be prosperous so that the dollar economy be stable, so that the dependent economical institutions like IT, textile industry and export organizations be prosperous. So not only for us, that's why our ancestors, they have very much glorified Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu, which includes the bullion economy of UK, the dollar economy of US, and the fuel economy, the fossil fuel economy of Middle East. So Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu is very much essential practically and also conceptually for the members of stock exchange and share exchange, etc. So anybody involved in industrialization, trade and commerce, certainly they are interdependent in this globalization and privatization era. So apart from these, then we have to say there is one basic model of inflation that is known as a Robert model. Robert, who is a great economist, he classified this inflation into three major steps. One is, first is known as the cash pull. The second is known as the demand. And third is known as built-in. So the built-in, first we start with built-in. What is known as built-in inflation? Built-in inflation, it just explains the type of inflation which deals with the price and wages, which is within the workers, the industrial relations and the labor consent and cooperation. Then the democratic as well as the domestic factors of disorganized, unorganized or ill-organized relations between price and wages for the workers, as well as the relations between the management and the working constituents. Then it results in type of inflation which is very negligible. And the second thing is a demand pull. Whenever more expenditure is made, whenever more expenditure is made, your expenditure that increases rapidly, unorganizedly, that creates that demand pull. So second is the cash flow. Whenever a person with a product increases the prices, it is with the supply, not with the demand. Demand pull deals with the demand. That is, the more you spend, This deals with the more they offer, more they demand for the product. Now the present oil prices hike, that comes under cash flow. Demand flow comes whenever you are increasing ability for expenditure, lavish expenditure, multi-dimensional expenditure occurs and built in within the industrial relation. These things are the major issues. Now the government, you know that, you see, there are a lot of things. It is known as a political knowledge game and gambling. Political knowledge is different from game. Political game is different from gambling. Now each and everybody, they comment or criticize the government that it is not controlling the inflation. If it would have been the other government, they have to face the same thing and they are going to do the same thing. And whatever they are going to do for balancing this thing, you see, it is known as hasty adjustment. What is it known as? Hasty adjustment. Whenever you are having an urge for money, a necessity for money, immediately you go for a hypervalent interest. You borrow from an unworthy person who is going to just crush your neck and not pay it. So we don't mind at the time of any necessity. So at the time of crisis, each and every government, not only for removing the crisis, but also to establish its own vote banks in the society, and also to reconsider, if the elections are in proximity, to reconsider the possibilities of their enthronement. So for political gaining and thronement, and also for getting the what we call janabhipraya or prajabhipraya, which is the concern of the wholesome public, they will do something without minding that it will create a very great inflation in the future. Everybody is going to do that because it is an unorganized structure of last two or three decades which cannot be immediately moved out. So there are few controlling measures as per the shastras. Whenever there is a sanchalana, achalana, we used to say. Sanchalana means that is hyperinflation. Achalana means that is inflation. Whenever these things occur in the society, there are some controlling measures. Number one, immediately what they can do is rate of interest will be increased. And new monetary policies will be implemented by the society. That is the second thing. And third thing is the wages and the prices that will go away. That will be very much increased. That also will be increased. Second is that is supply side economy. The real currency, along with the reference currency. What is the reference currency for us? That is gold. Gold and other valuables, they are known as reference currencies in economy, where the transaction between or exchange between this real currency and this other currency, reference currency, that will be fixed. And the other thing is new fiscal policy. Financial policy is different from fiscal policy. New fiscal policies, they will be implemented. Then recession will be to remove inflation. Then the two major things that they will do generally without no other way is increase of taxation and reducing expenses. If they increase taxation, then they'll say that the finance minister has increased and his vote will be very considerably reduced for the government. And whenever the expenses for the government regarding the health sector, agriculture sector, defense sector, if anything is reduced, and if it is reduced with the direct sectors like agriculture, animal husbandry, etc., immediately that will create a turmoil in the society. They will agitate. If it is in the defense, science and the technology and other things, the nation will stumble. So either they have to adopt these two things. They have to opt between only these two major things. One is to increase the taxation and to reduce the expenses. These are unavoidable things because either the policy or the budget or financial reforms are done only with the available resources. It carries the contributions of the yester political communities. Natural resources and utility areas are utility percentage of our country. Number three, it also carries the blunders of the previous political parties and the rulings. So each and every political party, ruling party, carries such a resource which has usage, improper usage, limited usage, blunders, achievements and contributions. All of these things are totally carried by a government. Immediately one person cannot come and reform unless he is having the patra or a conjurer's wand by waving which he can create everything. He is not a magician. So this is a very never-ending story, and these type of things will have mutual impact. What is known as phenomenon of mutual impact. Somebody is glorifyingly, they are growing to a greater extent. Somebody, they have been trampled by insufficiency and paucity. So whenever these people who are squeezing the wealth and resources of the normal people, when they grow, this growth will affect on those people. They suffer. Their sufferings will also reflect upon this community. the grown community, established community, in the form of this Sensex and other fallings. So these type of things is the reflection of, we have seen the reflection of the grown and established rich communities and poor people. That is very visible. Likewise, their reflection, due to various other paucity and other things, they will get into some stagnation, they will get to endorsed into some sort of back roll, which will create an established society in the course of a great industrial fall, great economic depression, inflation, deflation, recession, etc. So these type of retrospective underdevelopment and that is a reprocessing of one's own original status without development will happen at the time of the impact of this so-called people who are trampled by the growth, unorganized growth of a limited community. These things are totally unavoidable. So these are all some areas where we can control things. And majorly we want to say something, in 1990 also we faced the same inflation. But that was due to a domestic factor, point number one, that was due to a domestic factor, not due to these global factors, etc. So the problem with the government is it requires a different atmosphere. We have to just undergo one systemic study of these problems and the methodologies that have been used and reveal the same thing in a meeting with the financial secretaries. It is very, 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 what we call deplorable, as well as it is very melancholic to even think that they are using the same traditional anti-inflation instruments which have been used in the pre-liberalization era. Now we are in the liberalization era. Now we are having globalization, privatization and liberalization. There are three things. One is privatization within the country, then liberalization of others to come, globalization, then open door for all people to participate. So we are having these three isations. In this era, the same thing of already I told, that is increase of rates of interest and then new fiscal policies, then increase of taxation, reducing expense, cut rate in expense, all of the same traditional tools are used, which have been used in the pre-liberalization era. That is a very great problem. What we have to suggest is new things. Number one, we are having a fear of US dollar collapse. Always we are having that fear inside our mind. So we have to create two economies. And to create that economy, it will take two or three decades. One is US free or US independent economy. Second is an energy source, self-reliance energy source, wherein by we need not be dependent upon the Middle East economy. So these two things are not in the hands of stock exchange or the persons who just invest. It is in the hands of the universal think tanks to organize and develop these things. Then revaluation of money, currency must be done. Whenever the advanced economies, they advise, whenever there is a possibility of such inflation, revaluation of money, the currency must be revaluated. But when it is done, it will totally be against, the public mentality will be against the government. So the government takes measure in such a manner, even though that is not salubrious to the national economic development, they will not consider anything about the nation's development. They will consider about some factors which are for development, or even they will be ready to some stunt which will create in the minds of the people that this government is to be re-elected. So they are totally focusing on such thing. It is a common epidemic disease for all parties that have been formed or about to be formed. These things cannot be prevented. So this, how we can do that? So in a very major force, I have told in one of my lecture also, if you are having a strong construction using Coromandel or this KCP cement, it does not overrule the impact of an earthquake, which is a mega force. So whatever you do with your stock study, trend analysis, market study, softwares for predicting the Sensex points and our investment securities, howsoever you go, when it is affected by a mass and mega force, it is very difficult for us to organize ourselves. So it is a high return, high risk area wherein by we have entered. If we are going to get something, you are going to get a golden mountain, which you are going to that is utilized for all of your succeeding generations. So at the time of crisis, the same golden mountain will be there, but not in your hands, but falling on your head. No doubt it is a golden mountain. So this is the great, it is a high energy, high risk and high returns area. That is the problem with it. Same thing I want to say, if there is crisis now, this petroleum price hike, isn't it for China? Isn't it for USA and UK? Now you know what is the inflation rate of China, 8.7%. Is any politician talking about these things? Are the people worried about this inflation? Why? Aren't they responsible? Because the country is organized by such a capable group of organizers. irrespective of the various communities, and also the bribe or corruption or high-end this type of embracery is unavoidable in the global community. In spite of that, there is an organized system of growth. They will be indulging in such corruption, such development or massing their wealth, which does not affect the future generation or economy of the nation. They will be also, they will be squeezing and leeching the economy and self-development and benefiting their own society, dependents and relatives. It is very commonly envisioned in major developing countries, but it will be within the limitations. Within the limitations, they produce more, they consume more, and they steal more. But here, the production is very limited, and the distribution is more, that too, under-distribution, and the consumption is more. Stealing is more. That is the reason for that. Even in China that has now, it has announced $1 trillion of connectivity in trade recently. Will it be affected by this inflation? Certainly not, because they are having stable economic policies. And even if it is there, they are capable of reorganizing itself. It is not only with the government, but also the IQ level of the common people, understanding economy, politics and social factors. They know what is socio-economical political factors. Here the socio-economical political factors is not known to the common people. They are driven by election promises and election gifts. So with such a community, we cannot develop all of these things. These things are the common areas. Then the other thing which we want to say here is, inflation is entirely different from growth. Inflation is entirely different from growth. Now recently the finance minister, he has announced that it is growth, not now. Before few months, before this inflation becoming severe, he announced that it is growth. And at the time of growth, in the process of recovery, and there is no other possibility except rise of prices. Prices will be increased in terms of growth. We cannot expect that all everything will be improving and the prices will be stagnate the same. It is very impossible. So now we have to prove how it is inflation and how it is growth. You can clearly distinguish a child which is growing and child with inflammation or thyroid, everything. When it is abnormal, unorganized and clumsy, certainly we can understand that it is a glandular abnormality or a hormonal imbalance. So we can distinguish. So it, we have to study. And recent economists, they have told that this type of inflation was already predicted. And these type of people, they have forgotten to take two major steps. I have already told our economy is a dependent growth strategy. We are all dependent on external sources. Whenever we are there, we must shield. What is a shield? Having alternative sources. If there is petroleum, there are three sources. Getting petroleum and more stockage. Number two, trying to get petroleum or some other related gas or some other fuel or any other material which gives the same purpose and purport from other sources, number two. Number three, exploring the possibilities of availability of such related, connected, relevant, similar and proximate structure within the country itself. Number four, if any sources are not there, creating alternative sources for functioning of industrial and transportive services by means of electricity, hydropower, etc. These things are must be in the long run. These things are going to really solve the issue. And whenever you are going to hung in a Trisargu heaven with these people, whenever you are going to do with utmost and absolute dependability, you will be frequently subjected to the crisis and the consequential inflation. So this dependent strategy has been already known to all, and they have not made proper shields. And number two, no preventive measure has been taken in the previous 2 years. Still they know that it is going to rise. Even before 4 months, we have been discussing, either in a meeting with stock exchange or somewhere else, I have told that this oil price hike and this inflation will come. It is known to even a very common normal person who is very much experienced or exposed in this economy and geopolitical and geoeconomical studies. It is very quite common. So these things are the various factors which mind that we need a proper way of support from the government side, also in the terms of knowledge, in the terms of implementation, in the terms of the sincerity and rapidity. They must do it so quickly. So apart from this, now the recent survey for this inflation, they have given some reasons for which we are also responsible. We must understand something. We are getting both the benefits. And whenever we are getting the benefits, whenever we are getting the benefits of black money, whenever we are getting the benefits of corruption, we are happy. And whenever we are subjected to inflation, deflation and other crisis, domestic factors, we are sad. So we are getting both good and bad. And it is very nature for the human instinct, the pitiable instinct, that it will be sad whenever it is subjected to some worry. So the main factors that have been given here is, number one, hyper-expansive bank supply. the expansive bank credits, deficit financing. Immediately you know that everybody can get loan, but we tried, we could not. But most of the people in the society, debit card, some proof immediately. And after a few years, if they just prove that they are human beings, immediately they will be given a loan. Like that, it is known as a deficit financing. Deficit financing that gives you ill returns or procrastinated returns or bad debt. So this financial stagnation is due to the deficit financing levels. And there are some monetary factors and non-monetary factors. What are all the monetary factors? One is a high level of investment. High investment plan or huge investment plan, number one. The investment of government on huge non-developmental activities like defense, etc. Defense, they are spending millions of crores over decades. At this Sri Lanka border, this Jammu Kashmir border, these things are unavoidable. But there are a lot of other measures also. They must simultaneously go for all measures. So these things are known as non-developmental expenses of government. Huge non-governmental expenses. Number two, huge investment plans. Number three, huge indirect taxes that is offered by the government. Fourth thing is black money. Whenever there is black money forces you to purchase more property, to spend it lavishly, to get into the society for more things. If you get for more things, as the production is not evenly more, there will be more demand, less supply. So the prices will hike up. It is the reason for inflation. So each and every member of the society, normal person, they suffer. Normal persons for food and other movement, they suffer. And high persons, they also suffer. These people suffer for water, these people suffer for orange juice. That is the difference. So it is a common suffering, depending upon the need, the level of luxury or level of urgency or necessity of people they used to suffer. And also there are other non-monetary things. Six things have been given in the recent survey. And it starts with population. What we can do with population? It is a totalitarian study, demography. One person must do that. So it is population. Second thing is the calamity, natural disasters and other things. And the third thing is, it is corruption. And the fourth thing is the import prices, hike in the importing prices. And the fifth thing is monopoly. And sixth thing is utility of resources, either manpower or resources. Our India, now it has, we have utilized only the manpower as well as the resources, only one third. One third of the national resources have been used. And only one fifth of the manpower that is properly used. Lot of people are uneducated. Lot of people are very honestly serving for other countries. Most of the people are very lazily serving their own families. And other people are interested in immoral trafficking and other various other antisocial activities like smuggling and other things. So the manpower of the society has been diverted, dilapidated and diluted in various exoproductive, non-productive, improperly productive and infra-productive forms. So this is the reason for this recent economy. Now the RBI, they have announced, that OIB Reddy, he has announced that we are going to bring it back to 5%. And according to Shastra, it is told that we need some heat. If a person is too chill, he is dead. We need some temperature. And if a temperature exceeds a limit of security, then only we have to rush to the doctor. Normal heat, whenever a person works, he will have heat. Any developing country, according to the recent developmental economical status and survey, India must healthily have 6-7% of inflation. He told that he will bring it to 5. But 6-7% of inflation, that will always create an urgent demand in the society to work for more produce and other things. It is very reasonable. These fellows, they are not understanding. For just either consoling the people or for making the people their ever dependents, there somebody is saying that they will bring it to 2% or 1% or zero inflation. It is not going to be healthy to the society. A reasonable inflation is very much required. It is very much essential for the society. And the Shastras used to say two things. Stapyatam, establish everything. For example, if you save 1,000 rupees today, you can purchase 1 gram of gold. But you just to put it as an ideal saving for 10 years, where you are going to purchase the same gold for 2,000 rupees per gram, then the purchasability, what is inflation? Inflation is defined in economics that it is the lack of constant purchasability value of money. We can purchase anything by money, but constant purchasability value of money is lacking in inflation. That is not inflation. Likewise, if you are just ideally saving something just for security, you are going to lose money. That is, savings is a process of protection, but long-term saving is a process of loss. Because if you are saving money today, and if you are going to make it as an inert saving, and the same money, after 2 or 3 years, you are going to purchase the same commodity, the commodity price will be more, and your means will be the unit value of your currency automatically. So productive investment, there are two types of productive investment, which is known as investment for interest. Second is investment for returns. And whenever you are investing for returns, you must invest in certain areas where the rate of inflation will be lesser than your rate of returns. So you must not think that inflation itself is better than our investment. So we must invest in such an area where there is a sturdity. So here, there are a lot of people we have now groomed inside the stock exchange. We can classify them into some groups. One is mega companies who are in the safer zone. What is known as safety zone? Even the whole world is perishes, they won't suffer. Or they will suffer, the suffering is like ant bite. So they are known as mega zones. They are known as safety zones. And persons, those like Tata, Birla, Ambani, those who have reached those zones, what they will get is lesser profit. There are a lot of things which you used to say, that it is the green area, the pale green area, the pink area, the pale red area, the grey area, black area. These are all the areas which you say, used to say in Shastras to identify the fiscal position of a company or the monetary status of a person. So if a person is fertile with more resources, that is green. Sufficient profit, abundant profit, unlimited profit, limited profit, sufficient profit, little bit, that is a trivial profit, then profit, then a person's investment is safe, he is getting trivial loss, sufficient loss, exorbitant loss, total loss. All of these areas are there in that zonal map. Likewise, in the investment, these mega companies are there in the safety zone. They come under the first thing. Second thing is the rulers are the predominant measures which are taken by these people, those who monopolize the stock exchange. They are in the second level. Then in the third level, there are calculative investors, those who know something about the stock exchange, and limitedly those who invest, and they are very much interested in short selling. Immediately they want to sell. See, there are two types of instincts within the stock investors. One is avarice, second fear. Whenever the price has come down, immediately they will get fear that it will come further down, so immediately it will be sold. So whenever the prices go up, immediately they will get on avarice that it will further go up, then immediately they will purchase. These things are not that. There are also a lot of transient mode that we say in stock is transient mode. Sometimes it will appear that it has been increased or decreased, then it will be re-stabilized and organized. This type of understanding must be there. So these type of people are calculative. Fourth type of people are very safe. They are just consultants and advisors. They will just give you points and give you some ideas. They won't get into the risk of these things. So they are the safer thing. Fifth thing is aspirants. Aspirant means they are interested in stock. Everybody is doing share market business. Everybody is doing stock exchange. Why can't we do that? You see, this is char, that is share. What makes the difference? I will do that. So I want to get a larger amount of wealth resources in a very limited frame of time. The only way, that there are some other ways. Getting into politics, and second is getting into media. Third is printing our own currency, and fourth is getting into share. So one among the very limited resources for getting more wealth within a limited frame of time is this share market, which is very legalized, but not organized and systemized, but very legalized. It is not a taboo, or it is not against the policies of a government. So everybody is interested in that. They are known as aspirants. So these are the safety zone companies and the mega investors, the calculatives, consultants, and the aspirants, the basic investors. We are all having lot of such people here. So for these people, immediately what we can do, I already told that in global resources we cannot touch our hand. And also I have already told that most of the financial irregularities are due to the black money that is handled by the common people of the society, the well-established people of the society. So the people have 30% of the flaws within themselves, and the government has 30%. The nature, it has hold the other one-third, the final one-third of these things. What we can do is, in spite of all of these inflations, there are also some sturdy organizations. Wherever we have assets, lot of other companies are there, they have proper assets. And the second thing is, they have perennial demand for products and services in the world. They are evergreen in their products and services, number two. Number three, even if something occurs to the global market or the global geopolitical or economical crisis, they are capable of stabilizing themselves. And such company has competitive value always in the market, number four. Number fifth, that company can be taken over by somebody, even if it is some sort of organizational deficit inside a company, that will be because of the product value of the company, it will be taken over by somebody else and it will flourish. So if a company has these five qualities, that it is having perennial reliability and demand of service in the society, and number two, the company which has the sturdity of facts, and the company which is capable of re-stabilizing its own self within the these things, and number fourth, the company which is well infrastructuralized and very much established over the period of time, and a company where even the organizational deficit can result in the takeover by a capable tool or a capable hand which can remodelize or restructuralize the company. Such companies are very great in number. And the final thing what I want to say here is, even though we are spiritual nature, we must bother about economy. Because economic depression that will make the persons to be deeply immersed in mundane and filthy factors like food. Each and everybody will be worrying about those things. Somebody will be worrying about the petrol to their belly, and somebody will be for their Rolls Royce, somebody for Maruti 700, somebody for their flight. So it is just a demand or a necessity. So if the society is very much haunted or overruled by these type of deficient factors, then spiritual knowledge will not get into them. And also, even if you advise something spiritually, and all things will be ruled out. A country where there is imbalanced economy, where somebody flourish, where somebody perish, this type of imbalanced economy that will create lot of ethical and moral imbalances and abnormity. If ethics and morality does not rule, spiritualism cannot find any rule, except some people like who are doing rituals for stock exchange development and share value increase, those who are organizing pujas for share prediction and other things, those who are special prediction tools like astrologers and palmists, those who are specialists in share predictions. Unless these people are very much inclined towards benefiting such communities, other rest of the people in the real spiritual kingdom, they are known as pseudo spiritual kingdom, the real spiritual kingdom will be very much affected because of this imbalance. So apart from I was very much thinking about the global stock exchange, but then I thought about the NSE and this BSE, etc. So while we were thinking about various other things, then I have been put now in a position to think about this building and its development. So instead of very much widening our thought and proposal, instead of thinking about the global economy or global market or Bombay Stock Exchange and National Exchange, now we have to finally concentrate more upon the Stock Exchange of Hyderabad.
Regional.
And upon
regional.
Yes, yes, yes. It is told in the Shastras, more than, there are some 10 commandments which I want to say in some other lecture. One commandment I can say now. One is, where you are going to be benefited. You are a beneficiary, somebody is a benefactor. You are a beneficiary receiving it, somebody is going to be benefactor. So you have to take care. You are a beneficiary, you are taking care of yourself. At least twice or thrice you have to take care of your benefactor. You are going to school, that is a benefactor of knowledge to you. You are going to your office, that is a benefactor in the form of salary, interest or profit to you. So it is a stock exchange. It is your benefactor. It is your visible temple of fortune. It is the abode of your work and its rate of success. So if it is not being taken care, then certainly it is a very great curse on us. And whatever we do, the process of personality development and personal beautification, that results in no benefit, I think. So that may be not immediately possible. Even though we are interested, it has been told, and also we can infer that lot of hindering forces are there. It is a collective phenomenon. Whenever we are coming to an organization, there are group of people, and group of people, they come inside a proper area. It does not mean that they are all like-minded. As 100 people are traveling in the same bus, it does not mean that the 100 people will do the same work. But in an organization, bus is not an organization, it is transportation. You will get down at your stop and you will do your own work. It does not mean that you have traveled in that bus, so everybody do the same work. It is not that, because bus is not an organization. But this is an organization in which, in all the areas, we must be uniform and unanimous. And in the other areas, whereas our personal thing is there, liking music, eating food, wearing, everything that is personal. And whenever we are doing as a constitution, then certainly we all must be like-minded, and we must try to be like-minded, and ego clashes must be avoided, and total, I have done it, you have done it, it is known as ego. We have to do it. Anyhow, if we are doing the clash like this, then it is a total loss to both of us. So whenever it is coming to such point, then mutual integrity and understanding, forgivingness, adapting things, reasonable adjustment, not intolerable adjustment. Intolerable adjustment is dangerous to the organization. A reasonable adjustment. So it does not only require the policies of stock management and stock marketing or business. It also requires the proper ways of relation management, personality development, how to construct relation between like-minded people, how to create awareness about the economy and other things. So apart from mere stock, it is no doubt we are going to do only stock, but it requires also extracurricular skills like intuitive skills. There are three types of skills. I have already told anticipatory inflation. Some problems are going to come. It is predicted by our tabulation study over decades. It is known as chronological chart. That is known as anticipatory. Predictive means while you are looking through the various economical and political factors, if you have experience, you can predict. Intuitive is God-given thing. If a problem is come, we cannot solve the problem. At least we can do self-escapism by not investing those things. At least selling those things through short selling or something else, so that we will not be avoided. We will not be totally getting into that loss. So preventing from loss, minimizing loss, getting profit, boosting profit, four things are four dimensions of profit. Just profit is not profit. Boosting profit is also profit. Getting something is also profit. Not getting loss is also profit. If you want to get loss, minimization of that loss is also a profit. So intuitive, predictive and anticipatory systems are to be there. We can get the predictive systems from knowledgeable persons, valuable economists. You can get the anticipatory systems by tabulation and charts of your own stock exchange review and preview. You can get intuitive things only by the guidance of spiritual authorities. I wish you to get that intuitive thing, irrespective of the God or the God that you worship. You must get the consciousness level awakened by the intuitive thing of which you must guide yourself to minimize their loss. Also, you can take your life in a very peaceful way without much of anxiety and perplexity. So, I wish and bless that it shall be renovated soon, and at least the fans are to be reactivated for my comfort. The lips are becoming dry. So at least a minimum development of reactivation of the inbuilt systems, which will, there will be always conflict between people. When there is conflict between people, you know that if there is a place, whether stock exchange is going to rise or fall, this area is going to be appreciated, because it is an appreciable value irrespective. For immediate returns or immediate liquidation of funds, it may not be applicable, but at any time real estate is a value of appreciation. So this thing is a very valuable asset. It's a very big building. To get to procure such a building and to organize this thing is not a very easy thing. If you start now, already it has been a God-given gift for all of us. GGG, God-given gift for all of us. So it is our duty to take care of its health and restoration of its beauty, and also organizational beauty, structural beauty, organizational beauty, and success beauty. These three of the things must be assured by all of you. I am wish and bless and all members of the society, both like-minded and unlike-minded, to unite. Let the disputes be resolved, and let me be invited once more again in a very happy and prosperous talk. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.